of the FLAIR facility. So, FLAIR stands for Facility for Antiproton and Ion Research in Germany. So, I believe the main highlight, the main motivation of the FLAIR facility, and as you know, that a lot of Indian institutes and universities are involved in this project. So this is the picture of the lab from where I come from. I come from Tata Institute of Fundamental Research in Mumbai, it's in south of Bombay. We also have a very small accelerator. So I will try to give you some overview about the nuclear physics experiments which have been going on or which have been planned at FLAIR. So as you see, the FLAIR is Facility for Antiproton and Ion Research. There are many countries who are involved in this project, and this is the largest upcoming fundamental science project worldwide in this decade. This is Fordman research in nuclear physics, hadron physics, atomic and plasma physics, and applied physics. Large number of users are involved all across the world for this project. Many of them are from science, but many of them are also involved in building the facility. And India is playing a very big role in both accelerators and engineering experiments. So, the facility has a linear accelerator, and then there are a lot of ring accelerators used, which can generate beams from proton to uranium. Proton you can get of the order 90 GeV protons you can get, and uranium you can get up to like 35 GeV per nuclear. That's very large, high energy beams, primary beams can be produced in the facility. And you have the current, the beam intensity is also pretty high. When I explain what is secondary reactions, like from the primary reactions, you can generate radioactive beams. And these beams are having energy from 1.5 to 2 GeV per nucleon, and with a factor of 10,000 higher intensity than presently available, you can also get antiprotons of 3 to 30 GeV. There are also cooler and storage beams here for radioactive ion beams, antiprotons to do experiments. And there are a lot of technical challenges for doing beam cooling, rapid cycling of superconducting magnets, and these vacuum magnets. So, FLAIR, as you can see, that this is the synchrotron here, which is the main synchrotron. And FLAIR will start in a modular version, and these are the four experiments which are planned at FLAIR. One is for the upper experiment, which is for atomic physics and plasma and applications. Then compressed beryllium matter, then nuclear physics for infrared experiments for nuclear structure, astrophysics and reactions, and then we have this hadron spectroscopy experiments, which is fun. So this is the main synchrotron, and the beams at a high energy comes to these three different parts, where four different parts to do these four experiments. So this is the layout of the FLAIR facility. This is the existing one. Is the this part will be existing accelerator facility, which is GSL experimental lab. And this part, red part, is the thing which you want to make, which will be built for the FLAIR. So, first is the APA experiment for atomic physics, which is one of the four pillars of the FLAIR facility. So, APA stands for atomic physics and plasma physics and biophysics and applied physics. So, what is the main thrust area of this APA program is shown here. So, all of you know that with the charge, we can have the electrons, whatever are moving in the orbitals outside the nucleus, they have some kind of certain electric field because of the charge in the nucleus. Mm-hmm. Now, this is the velocity is called the Bohr velocity. Now, when you increase the charge of the nucleus, the velocity will increase. So, you have from say a proton, if you go to say J equal to 92 is Hungarian, then the electric field can go to very high level. This is the electric field of the 1s electron outside the Hungarian nucleus. That will really go to very high value, and you can get electric fields up to 10 to the power 20 volts per centimeter, and at that region you can do certain type of spectroscopy which is very fundamental, and you can get idea about the at such high velocity you can find that the TVD will be in the non-perturbative region, and you can test some of the predictions of the model where the relativistic electrons are moving around the Hungarian nucleus. So the question is, how you can produce such things? Imagine that you have uranium, so how many electrons are there?
92.
So in the 92, because of the high energy collision, here you can go to 1 GeV, you can remove almost 91 electrons from the nucleus. So you have only 1 electron left, and because of that, the velocity is very large, because it scales as it depends upon the charge of the nucleus, and because of which you go to a 3D non-perturbative region, and there are new type of precision measurements which are driving this progress. So apart from that, you can also do certain thermophilic related activity, because in the high intensity beams, they stop inside the target, they produce plasma of extreme density, and from there one can study equation of phase and phase transition and transport phenomena at this high pressure region. The other thing, here you can see that when you have premium 10 plus, this 30 mV per meter stuff in this material, you have a very large plasma which is produced, and one can study this and understand certain things about the equation of state of fluid. So there are also biophysics and material science can be done with these relativistic beams, and one of the things is that you can study the cosmic radiation study. So this is something which is very useful for future space program, where one can try to see that when people go to space, what type of radiation they will face. So those type of things one can study. One can also try to study that whenever you are sending equipments,